Very good morning to all of you. Today we are going to start a new chapter, that is chapter chemical, chapter number 14, chemical effect of electric current. This is the last chapter of your physics portion. It's very easy chapter and very interesting and even important chapter. So in this chemical effect of electric current, we are going to study many things which is related to this electric, means what is the effect of electrics, what gadgets are used, how what are anions, cations, what is electroplating, and many other more things. Before starting this chapter, I want to show you some electrical instrument. Like this is a battery. It has positive and negative terminals. Okay, this batteries you have seen in your at your home also. So this batteries contain both the terminals with a positive terminal and negative terminal. Okay, and you can see different types of battery, this and many more things which you can use. You have seen the switchboard. There also the switch is also, the switchboard is also an electrical instrument. Have you seen the tester which you for checking the charge we use the tester. Like suppose you are in your house, your bulb is not glowing, okay, at the night. So how you will check that whether the current is flowing from your switchboard or not? For that, what you will do, first you will use that tester. And this type of holes are there inside the switchboards if you have seen. So by checking on this, by putting this tester inside this holes, if your tester glows, means that portion of or that, if it is positive or negative and one is neutral, one charge is positive, one negative and one is neutral charges. If your circuit is clear, means if it is working, then the tester, if you will put inside, it will, the tester from the back, and it will glow, means the light inside the tester, it will glow. If not, then the tester will not glow. In this way, you can test whether the charges inside your circuits are working or not, it is working or it is not working. So similarly, you have different types of electrical instrument which you see nearby around yourself. So we are going to study all these things in our chapter. So one by one I will start. These are some electrical appliances. Just I told you, battery, switchboard, wires, LED, and many more things. This LEDs, it can be of different types, okay? 3 power, 2 power, and even this type of LED. Okay, this is the switchboard which I told you. On checking here with the tester, if it's glow, then it is working. LEDs, have you seen? These are batteries, okay, which has positive and negative terminal. Wires, if you see this wire, I'm having one. Okay, the outer portion of this wire is covered with the plastic, so that, and the inner portion of this wire, if you take out this plastic portion, you will see it with held with copper wires or copper aluminium wire and all. Why this is covered with this plastic? Okay, because you know plastic is good conductor of electricity. So if you touch that copper wire, you will get an electric shock. But if you touch this plastic wires, you will not get a touch. You will not get a shock. Why? Because the plastic is the good conductor of electricity, and that's why it is overcoated on the wires. Okay. So many different examples, many different instruments you can see nearby around you. So I find at least 5 instruments which you see nearby around you and which are electrical appliances, and write down in your copy. So the next portion we are going to see here is the example of NaCl. What is NaCl here? NaCl is a common salt. NaCl is common salt. When take one beaker and inside that beaker put some water inside that beaker and put some common salt inside it. Inside that water and dissolve the water. After dissolving it, will you be able to see the salt inside that beaker? Suppose this is a beaker. You have filled this with water, and after that, you have filled with this, you have dissolved NaCl inside this water. So after this NaCl get dissolved in the water, will you be able to see the NaCl in the dissolved in the water? No. this water. Okay, so how does this water break? How does this NaCl break inside this? So NaCl breaks by Na plus Cl. Na plus Cl, and Na will have positive charge and chlorine will have negative charge. Means Na means sodium, sodium chloride. NaCl means sodium chloride is there. Na is a metal, and chlorine is a gas there. So a metal always have a KCl, potassium chloride. Okay, here also if you break this potassium chloride, you will break into K plus L Cl minus. Okay, means K plus L Cl minus. Because potassium, sodium, these are metals, and metals are always having positively. It is always positively charged, so therefore it will have a positive charge inside. And chlorine is a gas, therefore minus negative charge will be there inside this. So on breaking this Na here, it will break into Na plus and Cl too, and Na plus and Cl. So Na will have positive side and chlorine will have negative side. So what you do in this beaker, if you put two terminals inside this. Now what are terminals? It may be a plate, it may be a wire, it may be a platinum wire or anything like this. Okay, so this electrode, if you put inside this, so this will act where one will be of positive charge and one will be of negative charge, and this is known as what, cation and anion. In next PPT I will show you this. And if you connect this through a wire, means suppose this is positively charged and this is negatively charged, and if you connect this with a wire, and now you have connected here with a switch, what happened? This circuits, it's that what happened? The circuit starts generating with the positive and electric charges, and what will have here? Because of this sudden generation of electricity, current will be produced inside this, and because of this electric switch, you are connected here. You will connect with this electric switch, or you can connect with the battery also. Like here, it is connected with the battery. These two are electrode, and this NaCl is there. It will break into Na plus and Cl minus. And here it is anode and cathode. What is anode? What is cathode? I will tell you in the next PPT. So here it is. See. Now, firstly, before that, I will tell you what are conductor. A material which allows electric current to pass through is, that is known as the conductor. Okay, means suppose this spoon, this all are the examples of electric current, because these are the material which we will use, and from this material what will have electric current will pass through them. So conductor, what are conductors? A material which can pass electric current through them, these are conductors, and these are the examples of this conductor. Now the next, okay, now what is insulator? The material which do not allow electric current to pass through them. Conductor which allow the current to pass through them, and insulator which do not allow the electric current to pass through this. Suppose examples are this cap, woolen, glass, plastics, chairs, tables, you can see. Can this pass electric current through them? No. Therefore they are known as the insulator, and conductor are known as those who allow the material which allow the electric current to pass through them, that are conductor. And the material which do not allow electric current to pass through them is insulator. Now see, what is iron? Iron means it is a charged atom or material. Okay, what is iron? It is an electrical charged atom or a molecule. So electrical charged atom or a molecule is known as iron, and this is having two types. One is cation and the other one is the anion. So what are cation and what are anion? So see, anion and cation. Anion are negatively charged ion, and cation are the positively charged ion. Okay, if you see, these are the structures of what is cation and what is anion. In the previous, where I have made this, one is positively charged and one is the negatively charged. So the negatively charged is known as the anion, and the positively charged is known as the cation. Okay. The next one is, what is electrode? It is an electrical conductor. contact with the non-metallic part of the circuit. Example, semiconductor and electrolyte. What is electrode? It is an electric conductor which is used to make contact with the non-metallic part. In which are non-metallic part of the circuit, it will make a contact with them and it will allow the electric current to pass through them. That is known as what? Electrode. See, now the next point is LED. LED means firstly the full form of LED is the light emitting diode. Okay, light emitting diode. Why it is known as diode? If you see the structure of this LED, one is having a more length and other is the short. Means one is longer and the other is the short. So the longer portion is charged with the positively charged. Here it is having positively charged and here it is having negative charge. Means two positive and negative charges are there. So therefore it is known as what, the diode. And it emits light. And LEDs are colorful. Therefore they emit light. Therefore it is known as light emitting diode. Okay. It is a semiconductor light source that emits light when current flow through. And when will govern current be flowing? And you will connect with it one bit positively charged and one with the negatively charged. So these are the examples of how LED look. And you have seen this in your at your home also. Okay, these are LEDs. Now, what is electroplating? In the process applying metal coating on other piece of metal. If you have seen that I will give you an example of jewelries. We people wear jewelries. Many people, they purchase silver jewelry and they put a coating of golden on it. Okay, they will purchase a jewelry of silver. Okay, made up of silver, but they will electroplate. They will put the coating of silver jewelry of the golden jewelry, and that process is known as what? Electroplating. Okay, and suppose these are many different examples given to you. Suppose the steel, iron, zinc, copper, they are covered with different type of plated with different types of materials. Material, different types of electroplating. See, here this watch is electroplated by golden plate. This mug is electroplated by the copper plate. This by the silver plate. This also by the silver plate. Okay, and this is plated by the chrome. Okay, so this the many types of electroplating you can see. Means a metal on which coating is done off by the another piece of metal. See, this instrument you can see nearby around you. Okay, so this is known as what? Electroplating. Okay, so in this chapter is very easy. You have to just see the read on the books and you will see what is positively charged, what is negatively charged ion known as, what is electroplating there, and what is electrode, what are anode, diode. This was a very short chapter, and in this chapter you are going to study about the circuits, how the current flow, how the NaCl breaks down. In this way, this much only is there in the chapter. So go through the chapter and write down the theoretical part which I have given in you the PDF form, and write down the preparer notes well, and thank you for that.